Everyone, welcome to the Cali Kim live stream. It's Monday. We live stream here every Monday at noon Pacific time, and I love how a lot of you are already joining me here in the chat. It's so much fun, this community. We really are a great supportive community and love to encourage people in their gardens. So I love to see people doing that ahead of time. So join in every Monday at noon Pacific time, and I try and get here in the live stream about 15 minutes ahead of time so that we can chat, find out how your week was, and I know a lot of you are experiencing a lot of cold. My backyard up in Canada, she said it was negative 45 degrees at nighttime. And Jack out in Maryland and a few other people out in Maryland said it was 30 degrees, snowing, or snow is on the way. So I know a lot of you are struggling through the cold winter. So hang in there and let's all think spring together, and maybe it'll help spring come a little bit sooner. We can get our gardens planted all that much sooner. So hi Nisha, how are you? So I know we have people joining us from all over the country. And Rod from Mexico down in Baja, Melissa from Mississippi. Hello, Patsella. Let's see who else is here. Samantha from Washington doing makeup and watching your tips. That's awesome. I love to watch videos while I'm getting ready in the morning, while I'm doing my makeup. I get all kinds of stuff watched while I'm just doing things around the house. So anyway, thank you so much for joining me. Today we're talking about three tips for starting your vegetable garden. Quick and simple, especially if you're a new gardener. But if you're a seasoned gardener, don't tune out, because you might learn something new, you never know. And also, we desperately need you seasoned gardeners here in the chat and here on the channel, because we learn so much from you, and I really love how this community encourages each other. So we're dying to hear your tips and tricks from you seasoned gardeners of how you've kept things quick and simple, and you can really encourage the beginning gardeners who are just getting started. So thanks so much for joining me. I want to mention and thank you to Everything Sunflowers and More. She shows up here faithfully every single Monday and moderates. I super appreciate it. And I don't know if you guys knew this, but she's a master gardener. She probably doesn't want to toot her own horn, but I'm going to toot it for her. Her name's Christy. She's a master gardener. She's a very good friend. She lives in Florida. So she can answer a lot of your questions. And she always is so encouraging and positive here on the Monday live stream. So thank you so much, Christy. So before we get started on the tips, I want to share our viewer of the week. If you've never joined our live stream, every week I look through the comments and through the emails, and whichever comment or email really strikes me, something I'm inspired by, I really like to read it here on the live stream. So today's viewer of the week is Victoria Greenwood. I have no idea if she's here on the live stream, but Victoria left a wonderful comment yesterday. I believe it was on the salsa garden video that we posted over the weekend. And Victoria says, I start my seeds around Valentine's Day. I'll be growing the same varieties this year along with many more. Last year I planted 80 different seeds. It was a bit overwhelming, so I picked my favorites and a couple of new ones to try out. I love getting exotic varieties in fun colors that are not available at my local stores. It makes my kids, ages 5 and 8, more likely to eat their vegetables, and they love helping me in the garden now. My daughter loves to snack on a variety of tiny tomatoes, with yellow pear being her favorite. My son enjoys edamame and colorful carrots such as the black nebula. And the reason why I chose this comment, guys, is because I'm so inspired by Victoria getting out there with her kids in the garden. We all know it's a lot more work when you bring your kids along, but it's so worth it because they learn so much, and not to mention the fact that now they're eating more vegetables. So they have a lot of fun. It builds great, fun family memories. And I really want to applaud her for bringing her kids out there and really giving her kids a love of vegetables, and also showing them where food comes from. Because believe it or not, a lot of kids don't know that these days. They just think carrots or oranges or lemons or whatever come from the grocery store. So it's so much easier. It's so fun and easy to bring them out there with you. And I am coming out with, hopefully in the next month or so, a kids seed collection that'll make it really fun and easy for you to garden with your kids. So make sure you stay tuned for that. So Victoria, thank you so much for sharing that with us. And make a comment on a video, send me an email, and you never know, you might be the viewer of the week next week. So guys, let's jump right in here to our first tip, and then we'll come back to the chat and take some questions. So the first tip for new gardeners or anyone starting a vegetable garden is just get started. Now, I know that seems very basic, but a lot of people really have a hard time just jumping in and getting going. I get the question all the time, how do I start? And the best way I can tell you to get started is by adhering to my favorite garden motto, and that is start simple and expand later. So the best way you can get started is something very, very simple. Just ask yourself, what vegetables do myself and my family like to eat? And then just pick one or two of those vegetables and plant them. So don't pick 10 or 20, just get started with one or two, get some confidence, build up your skills a little bit, and once you get that very first garden fresh harvest, you're gonna get some confidence, excitement, and the other vegetables that you wanna plant won't seem quite so intimidating. Now, what I love to tell people to start with is probably one of the earliest or easiest vegetables to plant, and I don't know if you guys can guess it or not, but my favorite to start with is lettuce. And start it in a container on your windowsill or in a little container outside. So here's one. I always have a little container on my windowsill of lettuce. You can see this one is in need of harvesting. It's been actually sitting out here in the sun and getting a little bit droopy this morning. So I got a little bit too much sun. I put it out here this morning so I'll be ready for my live stream. But just start with a little container of lettuce. It's so much fun, and you might even want to give your kids their own container. Have them sprinkle in a few lettuce seeds. And I have a lettuce seed collection that you can get started with if you need some seeds. It just takes all the guesswork out. It's got 5 packets in it, but it's really fun just to get them started on some lettuce, get your family started on lettuce, and it'll sprout in a couple of days. You can harvest it in about 2 to 3 weeks, and it's a great vegetable to get started with. So the other thing you can start with, I just saw a comment in the chat, I thought you were gonna say radishes, and that is actually one of the things that kids love to start with too, is radishes, because radishes grow from seed to harvest in probably around 3 weeks or so. So that's also a great vegetable to start with. And it is gonna be one of those two anyway, are gonna be one of, or two of the vegetables I'll be including in my kids' seed collection. If you have any other suggestions for seeds that you'd love to see in that collection, please leave me a comment on this video. I would love to hear your suggestions. So get started. Start simple, expand later. Once you get success with lettuce, other vegetables aren't gonna seem so intimidating, and you can get more of a garden started then. So that's tip number one. I would love to hear your tips here in the chat. If you have any other tips for helping a new gardener get started, I would love to hear it. So let's go over in the chat and see if there's any questions available. Okay, here's one from Samantha. How do you grow rosemary? It's the one thing I can't grow. Okay, Samantha, rosemary, I like to just pick up a little transplant from the garden center. It can be a little bit tricky to grow from seed. They're relatively inexpensive at the garden center. Pick one up, and rosemary is pretty drought tolerant once it gets established. You wanna pick a good sunny spot in your garden. The great thing about rosemary is it's super, super cold hardy. So I think it's zones, if I'm not mistaken, maybe 6 through 9, it's cold hardy. So you can plant it outside if you live in a warm winter climate like I do right now, or just start some indoors, get your little transplant, pot it up, put it indoors. It will do fine in a sunny windowsill, and then once the weather warms up a little bit, you can get it out in the garden. So hopefully that'll help you grow rosemary. Now I did see a couple of comments in the chat. Oh yes, and Deborah, good comment here. Rosemary branch in a cup of water roots well. So if you have a neighbor that has some rosemary, grab a cutting, like a soft root cutting or a soft stem cutting off their bush, and you can root it in water. I found if you put a little bit of worm tea in the water, it helps it root a lot faster. And then you could put it in a pot of soil. I do have a video on that if you want to check that out. And that way you get a free plant. So ask your neighbors if they have some. Okay, Nisha's mentioning she never has any luck with lettuce. So little tip on lettuce, it is a cool weather vegetable. So if you're having problems with it, it could be because you're growing it where it's too hot. So maybe if you have it in a sunny window, once it warms up outside, it might be a little bit too hot in that window. So you might have to kind of move it back a little bit, or super easy to grow it under a really simple grow light. But lettuce likes temperatures of 75 degrees or below. So once you get over 75 degrees, it is gonna tend to bolt. Now in my lettuce seed collection, I do have a couple of heat tolerant varieties that do well up to about 80 degrees. But eventually, if it gets 80 or above, your lettuce is going to struggle, and eventually it will bolt and go to seed. But you can grow heat-tolerant greens, such as kale and chard. Those do really well in hot temperatures. But make sure if you're growing it in a container, it gets plenty of water, and hopefully you'll have some good luck with it. But just make sure you keep it in the away from the window if it's going to get too hot. Okay, let's see here if there's a couple more questions before we move on to our second tip. Okay, Irene has a question. Hi, Irene. Nice to have you here today. I planted a new batch of carrot seeds in the grow bags. Should I cover them? I did last October. Okay, Irene, I'm thinking you probably covered them. I recommended at the time that I made the video to cover them because it helps keep the soil moist. Carrot seeds really need moist soil in order to germinate. So I like to cover them when the temperatures, you know, are kind of warm outside, because that way it helps the soil stay moist and it doesn't dry out and the seeds will germinate quicker. So it really depends on the weather where you live. Like right now here in California, it's not that hot. Today it's going to be maybe I think around 70 or so, which isn't that hot for us here. So if it gets much above that, you would definitely want to cover your container just to keep the soil moist. So the most important thing is to keep that soil moist while your carrot seeds are germinating. So hopefully that will help. Okay, jump off. I just harvested your lettuces last night. My wife was really impressed. That's awesome. Thank you so much, Jump Off, for growing my lettuce seed collection. And those fresh salads are super tasty. It's always great to impress your family. Okay, let me head over and talk about the second tip. Oh, after the second tip, you seasoned gardeners, make sure you get your tips ready to encourage the new gardeners with, okay? So the second tip is, I wanted to say about the first tip, just get started. One thing that I really love to encourage new gardeners to do that makes it really simple and also makes it really fun is to plant a theme garden. So you could do a salad garden, for example, with lettuce, maybe with tomatoes and cucumbers. You could also do the salsa garden, which I posted a video on that over the weekend, where you're growing tomatoes, peppers, cilantro, onions, everything you need for a salsa garden. It makes it really, really fun because you can just head out there and pick it. Super yummy, and you get to see all those beautiful vegetables in the garden. So that's a great fun thing to do with your kids as well. Get a salsa garden or a salad garden going, and you can always check out the seeds on my website too if you're not sure what to buy. So second tip for a new gardener starting out a vegetable garden is make sure that you grow the right vegetables in the right season. So this may seem really basic to a lot of you seasoned gardeners who are really used to the terms cool weather vegetables versus warm weather vegetables, but someone just asked me, I believe in a comment this morning, I live in the Los Angeles area, when do I get my seeds started? Well, you can pretty much get seeds started anytime, but you have to make sure you're growing the right vegetables for the right season. So keep it easy on yourself. Work with the weather, not against it. The cool weather vegetables really like temperatures of 75 degrees and under. A lot of them will take some light frosts. So those are great things to grow in a southern climate, like here in California. The cool weather vegetables are great to grow in the winter time, the very early spring. Those are things like the greens, like lettuces, broccoli, cauliflower, radishes, kohlrabi, collards, all the things that you'd find in my fall garden seed collection. Those are all cool weather vegetables. So you definitely want to grow the cool weather vegetables during the cooler temperatures. So here in California, any of those things you could grow right now. However, we are getting ready for springtime, and in the springtime, you're going to want to grow your warm weather, or the late spring and the summer, you're going to want to grow your warm weather vegetables. And those are things that enjoy the temperatures of like 75 to 90 degrees. They're good, like, you know, down to 50 degrees at nighttime, 50 to 60 degrees at nighttime. But those are things like we all know and love, the classic, like tomatoes, peppers, eggplants, cucumbers, warm heat tolerant vegetables like the kale, the chard, the beans. All those things are wonderful warm weather vegetables, and those things you'd like to start about 4 to 6 weeks before your last frost date of the spring. So that's the next thing we're going to talk about, is the frost date. So that's actually tip number three, and we're going to save that for just a moment. But keep it easy on yourself. Tip number one, just get started. Start simple, expand later. Tip number two, plant the right vegetables for the right season, the cool weather vegetables and the warm weather vegetables. So you can always Google it if you're not sure what vegetable is what temperature it takes. You can just Google it. Or you can take a look at my videos. I have plenty of videos on fall gardening and on spring gardening. You can get a good idea of what to start when. Okay, so hopefully that helps you guys who are brand new starting out. And I want to hear in the chat from you seasoned gardeners what tips you have to offer the people who are just starting out. So we're all in this together, and we all are going to grow our gardens together and just have a ton of fun. So Jason has a question. Hello, Jason. Welcome to today's live stream. Jason says, I live in a cold, snowy climate. Have I waited too long to grow garlic? Jason, the ideal time to get garlic planted is in the fall, but it's not too late. The only thing you might run into is that your ground might be frozen. So what I would suggest at this point in time is just to get some started in a container. So there's lots of great containers out there. You might even have like a 5-gallon bucket or something already that you could start one in. You could pick up a Smart Pots container, like the containers I have right behind me here actually were great for growing garlic. And you can go back and check out my garlic growing video. Get some planted now. Garlic actually really likes the cold weather. That needs that period of you know, cold weather. It goes dormant, and then once it starts to warm up, you're gonna see little green shoots, and you can harvest it about 6 months after you plant it. So go ahead and get some planted, and the worst thing that happens is that you're out some garlic bulbs, but it's always fun to experiment and try new things in the garden, so I say go for it. Okay, question here from Karen. Hello, Karen, welcome. Will you be doing a spring series? Absolutely, I'll be doing a spring series. It's so much fun to get our seeds started together. So make sure you stay tuned for that. I'm not sure exactly when it will be starting, but probably within the next month or so. But get some seeds started now, guys. Whatever you are, wherever you're at, whatever climate you're at, get something started. You can even grow indoors if you live in a super cold climate. Lettuce is a super easy thing to grow indoors. Some herbs, microgreens. I had this lettuce. She just showed this on Saturday's video, or not lettuce, cilantro. I just transplanted it in one of these little transplanter smart pots. And I think I had a question about this. It's about a gallon size, I believe. But these things are super handy. They're number one, great for growing herbs, but number two, they're super handy for transplanting because the sides peel away. So if you plant a tomato or something in it, you can transplant it in the garden. It's super, super handy. And those are, you can get over on at smartpots.com. and get a 10% discount if you use my code, Callie Kim. So let's see here. Oh, one more question. Rod, it's so great to have Rod on. It's always a great mindset, experiment in the garden. Absolutely. I mean, that's how you learn. That's how I started learning, just by trying different things. I'm always trying new things and experimenting. That's really the best way to learn, is just go for it. I know Rod has done that a lot in his garden there in Baja. So let's talk about the third tip, and then we'll come back and answer as many questions as we can before the live stream is over. And I kind of alluded to this a little bit earlier, but the third tip for starting your garden is make sure you pay attention to your first and last frost date of the season. Now in the springtime, if you're watching or here in the Northern Hemisphere, we'll be coming up on our last frost date throughout the country. And the reason why that date is so important is that you want to make sure that you're planting the right vegetables at the right time. For example, if you're having a last frost date of February or March, you don't want to put your tomatoes, which are warm weather vegetables, out in the garden before your last frost date, because they'll die. So tomatoes, the warm weather vegetables, most of those are frost sensitive. So you want to be really careful that you put them outside once the frost is gone, the soil is warmed up, so you're going to really have a great chance for success. So if you pay attention to those dates, you're going to make it easy on yourself. You're going to, again, work with the weather, not against it, and you're going to have a successful garden. And a lot of people say, how do I know when my first and last frost date is? Well, there's a great website called the Farmer's Almanac, and there'll be a link in this video, or if Christy, if you can post that in the chat here. And there's a frost date calculator on there. It's super simple. You just type in your zip code and it'll pull up the average last frost date for your area. But keep in mind, that is an estimation based on, you know, past year's history. So you always have to pay attention to the weather. And if you're getting a frost and you've already planted your tomatoes, you want to go outside and cover things up to make sure that they don't die. So anyway, guys, I would love to hear from you in the chat here. Cliff, hi, how are you? Some tips. And Cliff is offering actually a tip here for northern gardeners. You can do tomatoes early with a wall of water. So I think that's some type of a cover that you put on, Cliff. I know you've mentioned that to me before. I don't know exactly what that is. And Cliff says he's usually out in early April. So yes, you can. Thank you so much, Cliff, for offering that tip. You can definitely speed things up with a little bit of help. You can make some kind of a winter cover for your vegetables. You can warm your soil up by laying down black plastic and keeping things, getting things warm. But you can definitely do a few things to help speed up getting vegetables out in the garden. So Cliff, thank you very much for bringing that up. That's a great, great tip. Okay, here's a question from CFDD. I transplanted some plants into bigger containers to give them bigger space for the roots to grow, but they died in less than a week. Oh no, that's a bummer. How can I prevent that from happening next time? Okay, CFDD, let me know here in the chat what type of plants you were transplanting. And did you put them directly outside or did you transition them slowly to the outside? You do have to make sure when you're moving plants outside that you transition them very slowly. It's a process called hardening off. So you want to gradually increase the amount of sun that they get over a week's time before you put them outside into their permanent home. So if you just move them from outside to inside, you might have rushed it just a little bit. And Kira, thank you for this tip too. Don't transplant them too big of a container, just go up the next size. So yes, very good point, Kira. Thank you so much for bringing that up. You wanna go maybe about 25% to about a 25% larger container. So if you transplanted like a small little transplant, for example, into like a big 20 gallon container, like it's right behind me, that might've been just a little bit too much for it. So you might wanna move up gradually into a larger container, like this little gallon size or one of the little nursery pots or something. That way your plant won't go too much into transplant shock. So hopefully that'll help next time. Okay, let's see. Here's a great tip from Laura. New gardeners, definitely use Kim's tip to plant extra plants as some might not make it. Great point, Laura. Thank you so much for bringing that up. Things happen, right, guys? We get busy. We get bugs. Maybe our pets knock over or eat our plants. Maybe you forget to water them. Things just happen. So always, always, always plant backups. If you watched the salsa garden video over the weekend, you saw I planted a couple of plants of each variety. And that was kind of the minimal for me. I planted two plants of each type of variety from the salsa seed collection. You may even want to plant a couple of more just to make sure, because if one dies and you only have one backup. So that's a really, really great tip. So thank you so much. Okay, Jocelyn. And Jocelyn, I'm so glad you joined us today. I know you haven't been able to make it for a while, so I'm really, really glad that you're here today. What temperature to grow cucumbers? Can they be started indoors or can I directly sow them outdoors in 65 degree weather? Okay, Jocelyn, great question. Cucumbers, again, are a warm weather vegetable. So if your temperatures are, I'd say between 50 and 65 at night, then you're probably good to plant them right outside in the garden. But again, you might want to plant backups and plant some inside, plant some outside. That way, if you plant some inside, they'll get off to a really fast start. You're going to have seedlings you can put in the garden in about probably 3 to 4 weeks. And then your seeds that you direct seed out in the garden might take a little bit longer because of the cooler nighttime temperatures. But you know what? The only thing you're out is a couple of seeds. So I say again, experiment, give it a go, and let me know how things turn out. Okay, I did want to talk about a little bonus tip for brand new gardeners, and that is just set up some super simple grow lights. And this will really help get your seeds started off quick when you're starting seeds indoors. Now, don't stress about it. I know a lot of people are really intimidated by the thought of grow lights. They have absolutely no idea how to get them set up, and I totally get you. I was there when I first started too. It just seemed really, really scary and really intimidating. You go to Walmart, you go to Target, you go to Home Depot, what in the world do I buy? So if you watch the video on Saturday, there's this wonderful thing called a grow light box. Thanks to Gary over at the Rustic Garden for coming up with this great idea. And here I brought my grow light box out here to show you. So it's just one of the bins that you get at Target. It's hard to show on this little screen, but this one is 66 quarts. I forget how many gallons that is, but it's a pretty good size. You can fit a tray of seedlings in it. And it has this lid that you put on top that has a really simple clamp and then a LED light bulb. It has the correct amount of brightness and intensity to grow vegetables. So please go check out the 3 easy grow light setup video that Christy just posted a link for in the chat. There'll be a link down below. Do yourself a favor, get one of these set up in your house. It's super, super easy, or you can just get one of these clamp lights. There's links for all these supplies in the video description. But sometimes even if you have a sunny windowsill, it's just not enough to grow your seedlings. They might get a little bit leggy and then your seedlings won't be really strong. So do yourself a favor, spend $15 or $20, get yourself a simple grow light. There's plenty of resources out there. All the links are down below so you know exactly what to get. And definitely check out that grow light video because it's really not as scary as you might think. And it's really gonna help you get your seed started in a really simple way. Okay, questions here from the chat. Okay, here's a good question from Stephanie. Hello, Stephanie. I got a grow light and warming pad for Christmas. Well, that's a good gift for a gardener. Should I use both or are just the lights okay? Okay, so a heat mat is something you can use when you're starting warm weather vegetables, especially peppers and eggplants. Really need that heat mat underneath the seedling tray in order for them to germinate. But you know what, guys? I like to use it for all my warm weather vegetables. Tomatoes, cucumbers, peppers, especially eggplant, any of the warm weather vegetables like from the spring garden seed collection, the pepper collection, the tomato collection, any of those types of vegetables, they really get off to a fast start with the heat mat. So don't be afraid to use it for warm weather vegetables. However, for cold weather vegetables like your lettuces, like the cilantro, the onions, the carrots, anything that you grow that's a cool weather vegetables, you don't want to put it on the heat mat because they won't germinate. It's going to make the cold weather vegetables too hot. So just use it for the warm weather vegetables. Cold weather vegetables don't need it, but they both definitely need the lights. Okay, question here from, or comment from Debbie. Just be careful transplanting cucumbers. They don't like to have their roots disturbed. I plant cukes right out in the garden after Memorial Day. Okay, great tip, Debbie. Thank you so much for sharing that. And what I love to tell people is do what works best for you. So for Debbie, that's worked great for her. I haven't really had too much trouble with cucumbers transplanting, but again, do what works best for you. And definitely when you're transplanting them, be super careful about not disturbing the roots, and hopefully you'll have better luck. Okay, let's see here. Anybody else? Oh, you're losing me. I don't know why. You know, our internet has been kind of weird lately, but refresh and maybe that'll help. Okay, question from CFDD. If some seeds started germinating and the others didn't, not even weeks afterwards, does that mean they will never germinate? Well, if it's weeks afterwards, then I would say go ahead and plant some more. Who knows? You know, the germination rate isn't always 100%. The growing conditions aren't always perfect in your house, or outside, or maybe some animals came and got them. I know for me, when I plant lettuce outside, the birds like to pull out the seedlings, so oftentimes I have to go back and replant seedlings. So yes, always have those backups going. All right, here from Charisse. Hello, Charisse. I love your tomato collection. I'm from Trinidad in the Caribbean, and it is growing extremely well, and we'll be trying the pepper collection soon. That's awesome, Charisse. I love to hear feedback from people that are growing my collections, and I'm so happy that you're growing them in the Caribbean. I would love to see some pictures. So anytime you guys are growing my seed collections, send me a picture over my email, calliekim@calliekimgardeninghome.com. I would love to see pictures of your garden, or tag me if you post on social media. So, and make sure you guys are following me over on Instagram because I am posting every day over there. Things I'm doing in the garden as I'm walking around, post a lot of pictures on my stories from behind the scenes. And follow Camera Guy as well. My Instagram's CalliKim29 and his is CalliCameraGuy. He loves to post behind the scenes pictures, so that's a great way to see what's going on over here in the CalliKim garden. Okay, a couple more questions. And then we will shut down the live stream for the day, but we're going to be back next Monday at noon Pacific time. Okay, Jocelyn, another question about cucumbers. How much room do cucumbers need to grow? Can I grow cucumbers in a 10-gallon pot? Absolutely you can. I've grown cucumbers in a 5-gallon container before, like this one right behind me, the Cali Kim 5-gallon smart pots, and they seem to do just fine, especially if you grow the Space Master cucumber, which is in the small space seed collection, because it's a more compact variety. It's a little bit smaller of a plant. It doesn't trail off quite so tall as normal cucumber plants do. And you can easily grow one in a 10 or a 5-gallon container. Okay, Tom Martin. Hi, Tom. How important is it to have your soil tested? I have never had my soil tested, believe it or not. So if that's something they're interested in doing, I'd say go for it. It is a great way to see what your soil might be deficient on. So, you know, it's really pretty easy to do. I think you just send it into your local county extension service. There's lots of places that you can do that online and just send it in. But I've never done it. So, hey, I say go for it. Okay, let's see here. Just started hot pepper seeds from Micro Nerd. That's awesome. Peppers are one of those vegetables that you can get started early because they need a good time to grow inside. Maybe even 8 to 10 weeks to grow indoors before you get them planted outside. So you can start them 8 to 10 weeks before your last frost date, and then wait a couple weeks after your frost date before you get them planted, because they really love the warm soil. They like the warm nighttime temperatures, like 55 to 65. If you get them planted too soon, they're just going to sit there and not do much, and it might stunt their growth. So go for it, get your pepper planted, get your hot peppers planted now. And Cliff is saying, yes, soil tests are a good idea. So I'm sure it definitely can't hurt. I didn't know your seed collections are available over in the UK. I might have to ask for some as a Valentine's Day treat. Okay, yeah, you can get them in the UK. We used to ship to Australia, and then we had some problems getting them through customs. So unfortunately, we don't ship to Australia anymore, but we do ship to Canada, US, and the UK. So if you're in those areas, I'd be happy to ship some out to you. You can check them out on CaliKimGardenHome.com. Okay, guys, one more question and we are going to call it a day. Adrian, I love your backyard. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it. Let's see, any other questions? After so much rain, a lot of earthworms in my soil. That's awesome. I already read that one. Is it best to water from the bottom or top when starting seeds? Okay, I water from the bottom because I don't like the soil splashing on top of my, or the water splashing on top of my soil and kind of dislodging the seeds or the seedlings. And then it's just a healthier way to water in case you don't want to spread diseases or anything like that. And I feel like the soil just soaks up the water better if you water from the bottom, and that way you can go longer in between waterings as well. But make sure that if there's any water left in your seedling tray, after about 10 minutes or so, you dump it out, because you don't want your seedlings sitting in water and getting their roots rotted. So guys, that's gonna do it for me today. Oh, here's a great question from Irene. I wanted to make sure I touch on this. Can I use old soil for my containers again? Yes, you can. Don't waste your money and dump all your old potting mix out, because potting mix is expensive. You can easily refresh your soil just by maybe taking out a little bit of it and adding in some new soil, some new amendments. It definitely needs some new fertilizer, some more compost, worm castings. Now, what I found is if you use the good dirt soil, you can use it over and over and over again. So the cost is a little bit more upfront, but it's worth it, because I'm on like my fourth or fifth planting in a lot of my containers with the good dirt potting mix. It is so light and fluffy. It doesn't get compacted. And it's available now at a lot of Target stores. So check your local Target to see if it has it, or check the link in the video description down below if you want to purchase it online. So guys, this has been a lot of fun today, and look forward to seeing everyone on next Monday's live stream at noon Pacific time again. I hope you guys have a great week, and I hope for those of you that are in the cold north, I hope you warm up. And again, let's all think spring together. And hopefully it'll come a little bit sooner in your neck of the woods. All right, guys.